I have a question while reading through this, John. Whose fault is it when the construction drawings are not correct? Is it, I mean, who's responsible? Like, 'cause it said a couple times that the size indicated, the water main, the size of the pipe was not actually what was on the construction drawings.
These plans were reviewed initially when the conceptual plans were put together and forwarded to MoDOT. At that time, the pipe sizes that were indicated on the initial estimate and the review were correct. When the plans were drawn by our engineer, the pipe size on these three crossings was inadvertently listed as 6-inch as opposed to 8 or 12. They missed that. I missed it in my review. MoDOT missed it in their review.
I didn't know if they got, I guess, incorrectly drawn, like when they were first laid,
They were incorrectly drawn when they went from the concept drawings to the final drawings.
Okay.
These three crossings were carried forward, and they were labeled with the wrong size pipe.
Oh, okay.
It should have been picked up when I looked at the bid documents and saw that there wasn't any 12-inch pipe, and I know it's 12-inch pipe. We should have caught it then.
Any more questions for John? Any more questions from anybody else? I'll call the vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Motion carries. Next, I'd like a motion to approve a bid for water main relocation for alternate Route 63 Phase 2.
So moved.
Second. Okay. You just approved the change order for the relocations on the north half. This is the relocation required for the south half of the alternate 63 project. This portion of the project, the construction of the highway, has not yet been awarded by MoDOT. However, it has been advertised. This part of the project requires us to relocate the 12-inch water main where it crosses Eagle Trail. This is the water main that runs from the south edge of the city to the airport. It is a 12-inch main. It is specified and bid as a 12-inch main. It has to be basically rerouted to go around the southern interchange for the alternate route. So we're replacing a little over 4,000 feet of 12-inch water main. The low bid for this was from Willis Brothers Incorporated, $198,330. That's significantly below the engineer's estimate of $285,000. We recommend that the contract be awarded to the low bidder. Again, this contract and this cost will be reimbursed to the city by MoDOT.
And that's why you can't have
a local preference
because it's being reimbursed by MoDOT, correct?
That's correct. These are federal funds. And they would have been a local preference anyway. So.
Okay.
Any additional questions for John? Any additional questions out there? Okay. Call the vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Motion carries. How about a motion to approve a bid for a wheel-mounted 6-inch pump from Haynes Equipment?
So moved.
Second.
John.
Okay.
This is a pump to replace a 1986 pump of similar size. That pump has a gasoline engine. This pump is used as an emergency backup at lift stations. It's also used to pump from the sludge lagoon and also transport. If we have an emergency, we have to pump out one of our clarifiers at the wastewater plant or sludge lagoon or anything else, this pump can be used for that. We took bids for this. The low bid is from Haynes Equipment Company at $21,227. They bid a Gorman Rupp pump, which is what we wanted so that it's consistent with our other pumps, with a diesel engine, which came in below our budget amount. We had specified a gasoline engine. A diesel engine is far better. No one bid a gasoline engine. So our recommendation is that we accept the low bid from Haynes Equipment at $21,227. We budgeted $22,790 for this pump. It'll be charged to the wastewater account under their capital line.
Any questions for John? So that previous pump had been working for us for 24 years. Did we buy it 24 years ago?
We bought it in 86, yes.
In 86, wow.
Its resale value will be low.
Any questions from anyone else? Okay. I'll call the vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Now, could we have a motion and second to approve a bid for a 3/4-ton four-wheel truck from Love Grains?
So moved.
John.
Okay. This is a replacement for a 1998 3/4-ton four-wheel drive pickup truck used by the wastewater treatment plant. That truck currently has 99,085 miles on it. We solicited bids. We received bids from three firms and a no bid from Jim Robertson. We specified a diesel engine for this truck, the largest 3/4-ton trucks we have been converting several years ago to diesel engines in most of these trucks for durability, reliability, and basically making sure they last 8 to 10 years. Robertson was unable to bid a diesel engine. We received bids for two Fords and one Chevrolet from Roberts Auto Plaza, which is out of state. The low bid was from Love Green Ford, the local bidder, for $30,869. That is slightly over the amount that we had budgeted for this truck. We budgeted $28,210. We have $1,500 in the capital fund that we don't need for the pump. In addition, we will sell truck 228. It has a resale value of somewhere around $5,000 based on Kelley Blue Book for a fair condition. And so this truck will be sold, and those funds also will go back into the utility fund. So our recommendation is that we purchase this truck at the bid price from the low bidder, Love Green Ford.
Is this part of the replacement that we do of vehicles and stuff every so often, or is it starting to break down?
No, this is a scheduled replacement. This truck was rotated from one area to another and is now scheduled for replacement. It's going to be equipped with a flatbed as opposed to a pickup bed, because this truck will be used for hauling the pumps from the various lift stations, and also will pull the trailer to move the mowers around as we maintain the lift stations, lagoons, and other things that wastewater is responsible for. It is not set up for class number.
Oh, wow.
One of their other trucks is, though, but this one is not.
Further questions for John? Questions from anybody else? Seeing none, I'll call the vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries.
I will yield the podium to the gentleman from the public safety.